Go get him looking.
Oh, my eyes.
Okay. You okay?
God, this is all my fault. I saw Danny going into the treatment room before training and I didn't say anything.
Oh, that was a mistake.
How could you not say anything?
Right, well, I hope you've all said your goodbyes because we're never going to see him again.
Hey, that's enough. One more person says something that me and Beard don't understand, I'm going to have one of my son's classic temper tantrums. It's basically just him calling me a bunch of silly names, you know, like, I don't know, dummy head or poo-poo face or poo-poo dummy or, I don't know, what am I missing?
Pee-pee fingers.
Pee-pee fingers. Come on now, spill.
The treatment room is cursed.
What?
It's true.
Why is this the first time I'm hearing about this?
Well, I think it has a lot to do with grown men being embarrassed to admit that they believe in all this hoodoo, voodoo, juju business.
Hey, I don't believe it.
Okay, good. Then me and you, we're going to go look in that room.
No.
Why not?
Because, no.
Oh, heck! Oh, man. I mean, Danny was out there, what, an hour ago? Running circles on that pitch like a joyous, raven-haired golden retriever.
Coach, is it true in America you guys have so many beautiful dogs in pounds that some get put down for no reason?
That is true, Sam. But it's also something a lot of female singer-songwriters are trying to change.
It's okay. Hey, guys. Hey, fellas. Fellas, listen up, right?
Thank you guys for coming out. Look, I don't know a lot about this stuff. You know, I don't know about curses. But I do know this. They don't last forever. Okay, you look at the Boston Red Sox curse. That's over. Chicago Cubs, over. Heck, even Mr. Martin Scorsese finally won his Oscar. But I think we can all agree that The Departed is not necessarily his best work.
No.
That belongs to The Color of Money.
No, it's Goodfellas.
Agree to disagree.
Nah.
It's Asia Innocence, bruv.
Hey, beer.
Silence!
Boy, once the word gets out you lot are in here, this place will turn into a fucking zoo. Yeah. And the answer's Mean Streets.
Well, that is good.
You're all here because of this poster behind me. Mr. Higgins.
Are you a fast, fit fan of football?
That's solid alliteration right there.
Hundreds of those posters were put up around Richmond on the 18th of November, 1914. It was an invitation for young men to try out to be a professional footballer. It said to come to our stadium that day. And it was a lie.
In 1914, the war was raging. There was no tryout, just recruiters waiting to encourage those boys to fight the fight.
I enlisted 400 lads that day. Very few of them came home.
And after they enlisted, do you know where they went for their physical?
Oh, Christ, it's our treatment room, isn't it?
No, hey, no, fellas,
no, it was not, okay? It was. I'm sorry, I'm lying to you. I don't know why I'm lying to you. I'm sorry. I just wanted y'all to take a breath for a second.
Wait. What you're telling me is that we got 400 ghosts?
That's too many ghosts.
We cannot fight them all.
We're not going to have to fight them, Rashad.
Wait, so, Coach, how do we fix this? We can't change the past.
No, Sam. No, we cannot. But we can choose to honor it. Those young men, they made the ultimate sacrifice. So I think it's only fair that we sacrifice something of our own. I'm going to ask each and every one of you to go home tonight. Find something, an item, something personal, something that you truly value. And I want you to bring it tonight to the clubhouse at midnight.
We're all gonna fucking do it!
That's your captain talking right there.